Portion. A stepped bar with three different portion has a fixed support. This is a fixed support at one of its end. The stepped bar is subjected to a force as shown in the figure, subjected to the forces here. Determine the stresses and deformation induced in each portion and also find the net deformation induced in the stepped bar where E is equal to 200 GPa. Now this is the one end is fixed here. Now fixed end exert a reaction force. Reaction force whose direction we have to assume it. Now I am going to assume it in this direction. Let us consider this is the assumption R. I will consider the R. Assume it. This is the assume. Now f of x is equal to 0 or summation of forces along the x axis will be 0. I will consider this part. This has it treated as positive, positive, the arrow will be negative and this arrow will be negative. Now this arrow indicate negative here. Minus R plus 20, okay, because the arrow is here in this direction. Minus 40 plus 10 is equal to 0. Is equal to 0. Now this further becomes minus R minus 10 is equal to 0. Therefore, minus R is equal to 10. This minus indicate the direction we have considered is wrong. Therefore, we have to change this direction. That means you have to consider in the positive direction. The dotted line indicate the direction should be in this way. If it is a positive, then the assumed direction is correct. Now the assumed direction was in this way and it was negative. Therefore, you have to change the direction. Change the direction or reverse the direction. Now we have to consider this direction. Now this R will be 10 kilonewton. R will be 10 kilonewton. And the direction will be in this direction. Now we can measure it or calculate. Now this direction will be in this direction. Therefore, R, I am considering the R here. Next, plus 20 plus minus 40 plus 10 is equal to 0. Therefore, R minus 10 is equal to 0. Therefore, R is equal to 10. And this one is correct and this one is wrong because it is a minus. The assumed direction is negative here and this direction is correct. Now let us solve the problem. We have to consider the section 1. I am considering this is section 1, section 2, section 3. Section 1, I will consider the box. Now here 10 kilonewton. Now this side 20 kilonewton, 40 kilonewton and 10 kilonewton. Calculate this part. This indicate positive 20 minus 40 plus 10. The answer will be minus 10 kilonewton. That means minus indicate direction should be in this direction. This is 10 kilonewton and this will be 10 kilonewton. This arrow indicate minus. Therefore, this is the minus. Second section, section 2. Section 2, I will consider this part. First arrow, 10. Second, 20 on this plane. Here, 40. And here 10 kilonewton. Calculate positive 10, positive 20. That means positive 30. The arrow will be positive means this direction. Positive 30. On this side minus 40 plus 10. minus 30. Minus indicate direction. This is the direction. It is compressive, negative. It is also compressive, negative. 30 kilonewton, 30 kilonewton. Last part, this part. Section 3. Write it. This part. Again, 10 kilonewton, 20 kilonewton. One more, 40 kilonewton. And this will be 10. Measure it. 10 is positive, 20 also positive, 40 is negative. If you measure it, it will be minus 10 kilonewton. Minus indicate direction this side. Minus 10 kilonewton and this side 10 kilonewton. That means it is a tensile. It is a tensile. Now we have to find out the stress on each section. Stress. Section 1, we are finding the stress. Sigma 1 is equal to P1 A1. What is P? 10 kilonewton. 10 into 10 raised to 3. Divided by area. We are given is 300 mm square. 300 area. 333.3 newton per mm square. Now it is a compressive or tensile? Based on this one, it is compressive. Write it compressive. Next, section 2. 2. Sigma 2 is equal to P2 divided by A2. What is P2? 30. 30 into 10 raised to 3 divided by area 250. 250. It becomes 120 newton per mm square. It is also compressive. Last, I will write here. Section 3, P3, sigma 3 is equal to P3 divided by A3. What is P3? 10. 10 into 10 raised to 3 divided by area. Area will be 450. The answer will be for this one is 22.2 newton per mm square. But as per the diagram, it is tensile. Tensile. Now we have to find out the elongations. We are going to find out the elongation. How to find out the elongation? Section 1. Elongation, delta L1 is equal to P1 L1 divided by AE, A1 E. Now what is P as per the diagram? For this one it is 10. 10 into 10 raised to 3. What is L? L is 250. This one is L1, L2, L3. area into Young's modulus is 200. 200 is nothing but GPA. We have to convert into newton per mm square. 200 into 10 raised to 3 newton per mm square. Now 200 into 10 raised to 3. The answer for this one is 0.042 mm. It is also compressive. Now section 2, delta L2 is equal to P2 L2 divided by A2 E. What is P2? 30 kilonewton. Write it 30. 30 into 10 raised to 3 into length 320. 320 divided by area 250. 250 into 200 into 10 raised to 3. The answer is 0.192 mm. It's also compressive. Compressive. Negative compressive. Next, सेक्शन 3 डेल्टा एल 3 इज इक्वल टू पी 3 एल 3 डिवाइड बाय ए 3 ई. व्हाट इज पी 3? पी 3 इज नथिंग बट 10 किलोन्यूटन एंड पॉजिटिव है. 10 इंटू 10 टू 3 इंटू लेंथ 270 डिवाइडेड बाय ए 3 450 इंटू 200 इंटू 10 टू 3. आंसर फॉर दिस वन इज 0.03 mm. It is tensile based on the diagram. This is the diagram. It is a tensile. Now net elongation we have to find out. Net elongation or deformation delta L is equal to, first one is compressive minus delta L1, next is compressive minus delta 2 plus delta L3. It is a tensile. So substitute the value. Minus 0.042 minus 0.192 plus 0.03. The answer will be minus 0.204 mm. The negative sign indicate reduction in length. I am Santosh Gaidankar. Thank you very much.